What's up guys, Mustang 2005 here, back with another historic locations video. Today we're only doing three locations. It'll be a short video. But first I want to mention a few things, and if you want to skip this part, put a time code below. One, I'm doing things different today. Today, I'm trying to use auto mode on my camera. Normally I use manual mode and custom dial in my settings, but today I'm using automatic mode, which I never do, but I want to test it out and see how it looks. Second, I'm using a picture profile, a custom picture profile, so the colors may look a little different. I'm testing that out. So, a few tests today. Third, I'm starting to get tired. Thirdly, remember a few videos ago, maybe a month ago, I was doing a video, I think it was another historic locations video. I don't remember the title, but I had a sunroof leak. It was pouring and my sunroof started leaking. Remember that? Well, it turns out, and I fixed it, it turns out the sunroof, you know, the drain holes were clogged, so that's all it was. But because the sunroof was leaking and all that water got in, I think it got into the seatbelts and somehow messed up the seatbelt, and it was disabling my airbags because it thought I wasn't wearing my seatbelt. So I had to take it to the dealer, which screwed me on the price. Unbelievable. But the only reason I went to the dealership and not the guy I usually use for a mechanic, which is in New Jersey, Next Level Auto, is because, you know, it was an airbag issue. I wanted to make sure there was nothing serious going on. And when I asked him about it, he wasn't really too sure because he didn't come across the problem that I was having. I was getting a message that said service belt minder. So I went to the dealership only because to make sure that nothing serious was going on. There was no electrical issue because you're dealing with the airbags. It's a safety issue. You know, I had no airbags. That's a problem. So almost $500 friggin' dollars later, unbelievable, but it's fixed now. Better safe than sorry, right? So that's all I had to mention today. Now, all right, so our first spot today here is the Craig House. Now, I've been here before when I did the Monmouth County Battlefield State Park video, but I couldn't get over to this area because it was blocked off. This is the other side. I didn't know about this side. This is the side you're supposed to come on. The parking lot's over there. All right, so let's check this out. I don't know what this is all about. It's called the Craig's House. Of course, it has to do with the Revolutionary War, like all these spots. I forgot. All right, so I'm not sure what the Craig's House is. All the information will be linked in the description about this place, unless we find an information board, which might be down there. So this is the Craig's House. Let's see what it's all about. It's not open today. It says the sign that said that they only open on Sundays. So that's pretty cool. You can see you got the war fencing here. So you might be wondering if you bothered to watch my rants. Oh, it is a farm here. You might be wondering what the difference is between shooting an auto like I am right now and using custom manual settings to shoot video. Really the only difference, because you probably won't notice, the only difference is, you see this? See how it looks all weird? My hand looks all weird. Like this is manual mode. See how you have a nice motion blur now? That's the difference. All right, anyway. I want to do this quick because it was raining on the way here, and I don't know if it's going to come towards this way. I don't think so, though. Well, that's cool. Let's go see what it looks like on the back. All right, I switched to a different color profile now. So I'm testing out what's called a film simulation picture profile. It's a custom picture profile that's supposed to give a more stylish color. It's a film emulation based off a Fuji camera. And we'll see how this looks. So this is the second profile I'm using. I don't remember the names though, so I couldn't tell you. This is the back of it. I think I prefer this one more based on how I see my settings. But we'll see how the colors look. Huh. So I guess they do hunting here. Oh, here we go. Well, there's a whole bunch of information here. I'll put in the description below. I'll put in the description below a link to all the information, because I'm not going to read all that, because I want to make this a short video. All right, so let's go to the second spot. It's all within the area. This is Freehold. So let's go to the second spot. I think the second spot is Monmouth County Historical Society. Let's go check it out. This is turning out to be kind of a ranty historical video. Sorry about that. I know some people don't like it when I rant. Sometimes I just have to rant. By the way, last rant, and this is another picture profile. I'm not going to do any color grading at all for any of these picture profiles I use today. Just because I want to see how it comes out without any editing. Straight out of camera today. Okay, we're here at our next spot now. This is the Coven Hoven House, or also the Monmouth County Historical Society. Let's check it out. By the way, woof! It's a hot one today. It's 90 degrees, but it's humid. I'm okay with hot weather, but not when it's humid. Humid is too much. Let's go check this out. Pretty cool. I'm gonna switch to a different color profile now. This one is supposed to be good for low light or nighttime. And you can see the contrast went down a little bit there, so you can see a little better now since we're in the shade. Alright, if you didn't watch any of my ranting, I'm testing some things today while making this video. So if you're kind of lost about what I'm talking about. This is circa 1752, 53. I'll see you around back. Oh, there's the driveway. I had to park around the corner. I didn't see the driveway. Ah, here's a sign. Oh, it's just a welcome sign. Doesn't give any information. So the link will be in the description about this place. All right, let's go to our last spot. All right, this is the Oakley Farmhouse. There's a QR code there. You can get some more information, but I'll still put a link in the description. But it's closed, so we won't be able to see everything that's here. So real quick, we'll just see what's on the outside. It says here, woodshed circa 1750. It says tenant house circa 1750. Trying to do this quick because I don't know if it's gonna rain right now. The clouds are getting really dark, so I'm trying to kind of rush this. This is the smokehouse, circa 1750. You got these fences again. I kind of like this profile I'm using now. This is the last profile. I think this is called Fuji 400. I don't remember the names. I just kind of dialed the settings in. Harridge Barn. I don't know what that says down there. Actually, I think that's probably it. There's one more thing down there. So this is a toll house. Circa 1850. Wow, one of the last two remaining structures of its kind in New Jersey. I think I just felt a raindrop. Alright, that's it for this video. Don't forget to share, like, subscribe, click the bell, and I'll see you guys later. But, before I leave New Jersey, you know damn well I'm getting some ice cream. Jersey Freeze in Freehold. They have great ice cream. The video's over, but you still want to watch. I'm gonna go get ice cream now. Yeah, buddy. See you guys later.